Hello, it's Carly McElroy. Today I'm talking about expressions versus equations. This is a review. In the last video we talked about expressions. In this second video we're talking about equations. Equations have an equal sign, so we can solve them. Your final answer in an equation should be to state the value of the variable, such as k equals negative 3. Solve these equations. In the last video, we saw expressions are simplified, but equations are solved. And so, looking back at how we do this, in this case, I always want to get rid of the constant term that's near the variable. I get rid of that minus 8 by adding 8 to both sides. I get negative 4x, and then that negative 8 and positive 8, or minus 8 plus 8, are opposite, so they go away. I just had 0, I don't write it. And negative 8, positive 8 again over here, also 0. I like to do these examples a few times because people sometimes get confused when they see a 0 over there. What this is saying is negative 4 times something equals 0. Well, the only thing you could multiply negative 4 by to get 0 would be 0. So x is 0 here. If you don't remember, you then divide both sides by the coefficient. And those negative 4s are the same, so they cancel out to be 1, so I get 1x. I don't need to write the 1, but that's what I have, and 0 divided by negative 4 is just 0, so that would be our answer. And if you thought about that as a solution, checking it, negative 4 times 0 minus 8 is minus 8, or negative 8. Negative 4 times 0 goes away, and negative 8 equals negative 8, and that's it. For number 2, we want to get rid of the parentheses by distributing. So we take negative 3 times x, and then negative 3 times negative 4. Negative 3 times minus 4, those negative and minus meaning the same. So negative negative makes that a positive 12, and then minus 5. So again, if you're struggling with why is that sometimes a negative and sometimes a subtraction, it's both. Because minus 4, as we have it here, could be written as plus negative 4. Those two things are equivalent. So it doesn't matter whether you think of it as a negative 4 or a minus, it has the same effect. Before I can use the addition property of equality over here, like I did here, I need to combine like terms. Still got negative 16 over here. I've still got a negative 3x, but 12 minus 5 is 7. Of course, you can do any calculations on your calculator, but you should be working towards doing those without a calculator because that's how you get stronger by doing that. So now I want to get rid of the constant term that's by the variable, which is plus 7, so I'm going to subtract 7 from both sides. All right? And then I want to get that coefficient out of there. The coefficient in this problem is negative 3. So I want to divide both sides by negative 3. And that gives me x over here because negative 3's cancel each other exactly. And you get x. You get 1x. Don't need to write the 1. Over here, a negative and a negative cancel each other. But then I'm left with the 23/3. Sorry, I should have given that a little more space. X equals 23/3. I could write it this way on the x on the left or the right, but don't change it to a decimal. Don't change it to a mixed number unless you're specifically asked to. Leave it as an improper fraction. Improper fraction is perfectly acceptable. Okay, next one, solve this equation. This equation I put in here for a few reasons. There's several things that we have to do. Notice that we're not going to stop solving until we can state something like this, where we know what the variable equals. That's what our final answers look like. So, negative 7a and positive a, those are like terms over here. So I'm going to combine those. I have 7 negatives and 1 positive, so I have 6 negatives. You always simplify both sides of the equation before you start moving things left or right. So if you don't remember that, go back and watch our introductory, equations overview. That would be a good one to go to see about that process. Now in here, the 4a has nothing to do with this parentheses. I'm going to change this to a 1 so I can see that what I'm actually distributing here is a minus 1. Negative 1 times a is now negative a, and negative 1 times negative 6 is now positive 6. Now, I can simplify the right side. Left side still just hanging out here as negative 6a minus 3. And 4a, if I take 1a away, I have 3a's. And now I'm going to move the a's together, or I can move the numbers. The thing is, I want to get the variable terms on one side and the constant terms on the other. The constant terms are those terms that don't have a variable attached. It doesn't matter which one I do first, but I'm going to do the a's first. I'm going to move the a's to the left, so I want to get rid of this term, and that is minus 3a. That's where some students get a little freaked out, because when they're in the math class, they want somebody to tell them exactly what to do. And when you're in a situation like this, you have four choices. If you have negative 6a minus 3 equals 3a plus 6, I just chose to get rid of the 3a. But you could start by, let's say, getting rid of the 3. It's going to give you the same answer in the end. It's just a different way to get there. Just like if you were walking to somebody's house, you have choices of different ways to arrive at the same place. Don't get hung up on that. Just remember you can move any one of those four terms. But since I moved the a's to the left, now I'm committed to moving my constant terms to the right. Whereas here, if they move the constant terms to the right, now we're committed to moving that to the left or whatever. So we have different, after we choose our first step, it kind of changes what our second step is going to be. But the final answer will be the same. So now I'm going to get rid of that constant term by adding. And then I'm going to divide by the coefficient. The coefficient is negative 9. Negative 9 divided by negative 9 is a positive 1, so I just get a, and then 9 divided by negative 9 is 1. And that's what I think is the answer. What about over here? If I subtracted 3a from both sides, I get negative a equals 9, and dividing, I get the same exact thing, a is negative 1. So you could have also, at this stage, added 6a to both sides. That would have been fine. You would have gotten the same answer. And you can, of course, check that by plugging in a negative 1 into that equation. Let's do it in the shortcut fashion. What is negative 7 times negative 1? Well, that would be 7. Then I have negative 3. Then I have just a, which is a negative 1. Over here, I have 4 times a. That's 4 times negative 1, or negative 4, minus negative 1. Minus 6. So I just plugged negative 1 in. I did some multiplication along the way. On this side, I have 7 minus 3, which is 4, plus negative 1, which is 3. On this side, I have negative 4 minus negative 1 minus 6, which is minus 7. And that is negative 4 plus 7. Negative 4 plus 7 is 3, and there's my check. So I know that it's true. If I plug it in, I get the same thing on both sides. Okay, two more, number 4 and number 5. All these examples I try to choose for a specific reason. I want you to see some that look a little different, and number 4 looks a little different, but I want to isolate the variable, and I want to get rid of the constant term near that variable. Here's my variable n, and here's the constant term that's over here. 2 is actually a coefficient. It's like multiplying by 1/2 there. So I want to get rid of the plus 4 by doing the opposite of addition, which is subtraction. Negative 6 and negative 4 is negative 10. Now I want to get rid of that coefficient, which is actually a half. And so what I'm going to do when I see a number divided by something, I'm going to multiply. Because the point is to get those things to cancel. And if I have a 2 in the denominator and I multiply by 2 in the numerator, they're going to cancel. But I have to do the same thing over here. I have to multiply 2 on both sides, just like I have to divide by 9 on both sides or whatever. 2 times negative 10 is negative 20 equals n. That worked out nicely. All right, and then the last one. I want to distribute to get rid of parentheses. So I have 3 that has nothing to do with that. then 4 times negative 2a is negative 8a. 4 times negative 1 is negative 4. And this is not simplifiable on the right because they're not like terms. One's an a and one doesn't have an a. So you can still simplify the left. If I have 3 and I subtract 4, remember, take the sign in front of the number. 3 and subtracting 4 gives me negative 1. I still have the 8a term. Now I'm going to move things around. Again, I have choices just like I did up here. I could move the a's to the right. I can move the numbers to the left. I can do whatever I want. I'm going to specifically do something a little differently to show you it doesn't matter. So before, I've always put the variable on the left when I have a choice. So I'm going to move the variable to the right. So plus 8a on both sides. You have to get used to every problem. You might approach it very similarly, but slight differences. That's what it's about. Just like in life, you know, every person's a little different. You can't expect to, okay, I know people that have red hair always act like this. No, sometimes they act a little different, right? So you have to be open to that. Now I want to get rid of the minus 3 or subtract 3 by adding, because that's the opposite. I want those terms to go away, and these are additive inverses. They drop out, and that leaves 13a. And over here, negative 1 and positive 3, I have more positives by 2, so I get 2. And divide both sides by 13, and I get a equals 2 thirteenths. Again, it's a fraction. I'm not going to change it. I don't want to change it to a decimal. I just want to leave it as it is. Okay, I hope you have a fantastic